This very short video will describe the use of this map application for viewing the low and moderate income data that is based on the ACS. The first time you use this app, you will want to read all the important information on this page. Now to get started, click Open, click View Application. Now the easiest way to start to see the data and look at your service areas is to zoom in to where you need to go. And the easiest way to zoom is to just type the city and state. You can close the pop-up. You can also scroll with the mouse to zoom in or use the arrows above. Now that I've zoomed in, my layers will start to appear. There's too much data for us to show the layers at the national level. So when you zoom in, you do start to see the information. We have the block group layer appearing by default. Turn on the place layer. It is recommended that you only turn on one layer at a time. If you use multiple geographies and they overlap and you create a service area with overlapping geographies, you do run the risk of double counting residents. So this place layer, if you click on the map, you can see the data. This is all the same data that is in the table that's available on the HUD exchange for the ACS-based LMISD. And this particular Mount Rainier has 51.54% LMI. The places are particularly useful for the state CDBG program in rural areas where block groups are typically larger than places. We also have county subdivisions, counties, and CDBG jurisdictions. I'm going to turn the block group layer back on, and I'll go to my neighborhood here. Now, on this map, there is a community center that we're going to do a hypothetical activity at. I'm going to turn on the base map gallery here and change the base map to a satellite image. And you can see right here is my community center with the white roof next to the ballpark. So I've done a little market study in my head, and I know that the service area for this particular activity is going to be these five block groups. Here, 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 and here. Because I'm combining multiple geographies, I can't just average the percentages. I need to do a little bit of a calculation. So what I will do is jot down the low mod number. This is the number of low and moderate income people in this geography, and the low mod universe. This is the total number of people in the geography. Jot those two numbers down for each area. Now, when I have those all written down, I total them up. I divide the two totals, and that's my LMI percentage for this service area for this hypothetical activity. And as you can see, it's 50.9%. It doesn't comply with the 51% standard. So that means I could potentially look at complying with another national objective for this activity. Depending on the type of activity it is, it might qualify under clientele or jobs, maybe a different type of activity. If I have doubts about the data, I can always do my own survey. We have guidance on performing a statistically sound survey. I hope you've enjoyed this short instructional video. The intro page to this application had more information on links to useful information, the notices for state CDBG and entitlement CDBG, and other links to get help with the application should you need it. Thank you very much, and have a good day.